It is no secret that snowboarding can be an expensive sport. And if it's your first time looking into buying your own gear, it may seem a daunting task as you begin to add up prices in your head. So in this video, I'm going to be breaking down exactly how much you should be spending on which gear so you can get the best bang for your buck. If you're new here, I'm Shane Serrano and this is Search of Snowboarding. Through this channel, we're working on building a community of shredders and rippers while delivering you as much stoke as we can through our videos. So hit that subscribe button if you want to join along. With all the gear that we'll be discussing, you'll tend to see that the more money you spend on a piece of equipment, the more performance you'll get out of that piece of equipment. And this might correlate in terms of a stiffer product or a more responsive product. But looking at how much performance you want to get out of a product will be up to you, depending on your experience level and depending on how often you plan on going snowboarding. If you're a beginner and you're going to go out on the mountain 5 or less times this winter, you may shoot towards a product that is a little cheaper and therefore a little less performance, just so you can have your own gear and get out there. But if you're really looking to progress your ability with snowboarding and plan on doing it as much as you can in the winter, the more performance you can get out of a product, the better. All right, so starting this off with the number one most important piece of gear that you can own, we're gonna be looking at boots. Now, for most people who rent gear and slowly start building their arsenal of personal gear that they own, boots is the first place that they should start. It all starts with having comfortable feet and a boot that is fit for your foot shape. Everybody's feet are so different, and that's why it's really important to find a boot that works for you. But basically, when you're gonna go look at the prices of boots, the line that is gonna separate boots is about $350. Below that number, you're gonna get a much softer flexing boot that might not have as good of a fit and support as a higher end boot. You'll also find that you might not have as good of a sole and as good of a liner in a cheaper boot than you will in a more expensive boot. Above that $350 price range, you're gonna see better options for lacing systems, whether it is a speed lace system or a double boa. And the biggest thing in the difference of single boa and double boa, which you will see single below $350 and double above $350, is how it tightens the boot. This is really important because on a double boa boot, you have a boa that adjusts the lower portion of the boot and an upper boa that adjusts the upper portion of a boot. It's really key to have two different zones that tighten these two different areas on a boot. And you'll see this also in speed zone, where one string tightens the lower and one string tightens the upper portion of the boot. If you have a boot that it only uses one system to tighten the entire boot, you might find that riding through the day, certain portions of the boot will loosen, and that's not something you want. Some of the key features that you'll see in a higher end boot are gonna be a much better sole, whether it is a Vibram sole, a Michelin sole, or a sole that is custom to that brand. This is gonna give you better grip, whether you're walking through an icy parking lot or hiking a back bowl. You'll also find a much better liner in the boot, whether that means a better internal lacing system to keep your ankle and your foot cinched down snug in that boot, or just a better fit overall. If you are in the market for boots, go and check out my video up here that explains everything you need to know about buying your own snowboard boots. Now, moving on to the second most important piece of all the gear, and this is the one that is the most fun to shop for, and that is, of course, the actual snowboard. When you're looking at boards, the price difference that you'll see that separates a great board from a lower end board is gonna be about $400. And these two categories are really gonna separate how well the board rides, how fast it is, how durable it is, and how much technology is in it. One of the biggest things you'll see in that difference below and above $400 is the construction of the board, mainly in the base material. In a board that is below 400 and sometimes even below 300, you'll have a base which is called an extruded base. And what that is pretty much just a sheet of P-Tex. So it's solid, it doesn't have pores, and you can't really wax it. That means that you won't be going as fast as you will on a higher end board. Now, on a board that is above that $400 range, like this Capita DOA, you'll get what is called a sintered base. And that means there are pores in this base, so when you go to wax it, the wax sinks into those pores, so it keeps you running faster for much longer. In the actual core of the snowboard, you'll see a difference in the materials that get used. So in a higher end board, you'll see better woods, which means snappier, more lively boards that weigh less and that will keep their life longer. You'll also see other components, whether it is a carbon inlay or carbon stringers, basalt stringers, and other things like this that'll change the flex of the board in certain spots change the torsional flexion to give you more stability, and just add more to the board to give you a much better ride than a cheaper board that is not gonna have these elements in it. And of course, in that higher end board, you're gonna see the latest and greatest technology that is coming out of snowboarding, whether that's certain core components, like we mentioned, or certain specifications like taper or a certain side cut that gives you the best ride that's available. And now the last piece of equipment that we'll be talking about is, of course, bindings. And now bindings are not gonna change your ride quite as much from model to model as, say, a board will or as, say, boots will. And that's why we're saving bindings for last. Now the price difference you're gonna see in bindings is a little more wishy-washy, but I'm gonna put it right at around $250. Below that, you're gonna get a much softer flexing binding, so not quite as much support and not quite as much comfortability. On the straps of a lower end binding, you may still see some foam and stitching components on the straps. Those tend to break down more quickly and just won't last as long. But on a higher end binding, you'll now start to see injected molded straps. And what this means is these straps pretty much last forever. They distribute the pressure across your boot evenly, so you don't have any pressure points grabbing your boot weird, and they just make for a much more comfortable fit between your boot and your binding. Again, in that higher end binding, you'll also see the latest technology that companies are starting to play with, whether it is in the base material of the binding. Union is starting to use certain rubberized components to dampen some chatter, or as I just mentioned, more comfortable straps. I hope that with all of this information, it'll help you in deciding on which gear is more important for you to buy, or how much you'll be looking into spending on all of these pieces of gear. If you have any questions, leave them down below in the comment section and I will get to them ASAP. Otherwise, thanks for watching and we'll catch you in the next video. Peace.